Hello. All right. We're doing some test flying in the TBM here. I've gone into the CLS to SIM software and working on the TBM profile now. Actually, it's quite easy now that I've got a base set up for general aviation, just a couple little tweaks as per flight model, and we're hand flying the aircraft. Seeing how what she needs. Actually doing quite well. I've gone in and had to make a change to the speed. Red line is 265, I believe, 266. So adjusted that using pretty much the same forces, just left them alone as I did set in the Baron, and it feels great. So now it's just a matter of dialing in the null zone center, which I think I'm just about there. Is a little bit too much. You can tell a big difference in the models. So I made an adjustment to that where fingertip pressure here to keep it flying straight. This one's a little more wobbly. There we go. Yeah, about as trimmed as I'm going to get it, so the rest is just keeping the yoke. Light little pressures, all right. So we're at 18,000 feet, I'm set. I want about 100%, 99% torque. There we go, that's full power. No way this plane approaches red line unless you're in a dive, a steep dive. So it's 310 knot ground, so that's very acceptable. Also went in and set up the new Navigraph features in the G5000, 3000. It's all active. I've got a different flight plan than what I'm doing. I'm just flying circles from over the keys here. See what we need for any adjustments, and I think I've about got her dialed in. So now let's go back to autopilot mode. It's stable. Release the autopilot. Perfect. Real sensitive aircraft for sure. We're nice. You gotta be patient with that pitch, getting it trimmed in. The roll feels good. pitch is a lot stiffer, and we got about our ratio working right, or 1-2-4 ratio. Foot bust there. Let's climb back up, get our 18, and practice left right turns. There's roll mode, so let's go do a 90 degree turn left. That's going to push me back if I go to heading mode. Nope. Alright, so this one's got yaw dampers, so you don't need so much rudder work in a turn. Let's find the right amount of back pressure. Stay within my plus or minus 100 of 18,000. So you don't see the altimeter beginning to roll too awful quick till you get above about 200 feet per minute, 250. And then it starts rolling fairly quick. So as long as you keep about a plus or minus 250 feet per minute climb rate, you can keep that pitch under control. There's level out. Back to roll mode. Turn back 90 to the right. So if that black square TBM 850 ever releases, I'll have the profile ready to go for it. Imagine I'll be doing some flying. All right, let's roll. We'll go back to heading mode. And stay with the flight director. Back pressure. Stay in the back pressure. So I narrowed the null zone a little bit from the bearing. Likes a little more precision in the dead zone there. That's a good turn. That's about all I could do with it. I can go, let's see, let's punch vertical speed. Set the altitude up higher. Pilot, we'll climb up. Initial 1,500 feet per minute, so we get the airspeed to drop. Heck, let's go to 30. I think the ceiling on this plane's 31,000, so we'll go 30. We got our bleeds on for pressurization. Alright, so if we can get it back to about 160, let's go ahead and increase vertical speed. Get it slow down up to 3,000 feet per minute. Turn it out the flight level change mode. Captured 160. Let her do her thing. Standard 2980. Looks just outstanding down there. Keep in our torque. Half back. We'll go, yep, it's active. All right, cool. See what kind of speed we can get up here at altitude. Our winds are 313 at 24. About an 8 o'clock wind. Cabin pressure, so leaders on. Alright, that took care of itself. We're safe. Okay, we're maxed on our torque. Let's see what kind of speed we can get. About the limits of the airplane. 313 on the ground. Looks like we've got a little moisture out there. Four ground speed and rising. I'm just going to slow down about 193, 330 knot ground speed. It's with the side wind, 330 knots. I think that's going to be max. Autopilot away, a little bit of hand flying at speed. Indicated 33. All she'll do. Let's get out of heading mode. We'll turn here.
Bust that 100. Push the nose over. A little bit of heaviness to the nose, pushing her down. Let's no way we'd get near red line. Down. 266 is red line, it's not changing. 341. Pretty good amount of pressure on that pitch. Ailerons are heavier. The rudder's pretty heavy. No way we'd be flying this airplane like this. Push that nose on down. Some opposite pedal here. $260, $346. I got a real heavy control system. Ah, you know. I'm going into Key West and put her on the ground. The marathon will be closer. Drop her on down, pull that power. Show that speed. Not bad. I'll call that profile good. Get rid of our flight director. How's the glides on? Got the yaw damper button assigned. So. Bound for Marathon, we'll put her on the ground. Call it good.
see what the forces feel like as we slow her down. Let torque on back. See what kind of the sit rate we get at this trim setting. Be below 200 knots to bring in the inertial separator. Well, I think it's official. My two favorite GAs to date are the Black Square Twin Baron and the TBM 930. Two different avionics packages. Bruno profiles are set. This one is a little bit easier to fly due to less pilot workload with buttons and switches. A little bit more complicated on working through the avionics and what all it can do. Still looking forward to the Black Square TBM 850. This just looks so nice out the wing. It's got great wing views, nice cockpit. I need to look around, see if there's any other cockpit paints out there, just to see what's available. But this is one nice aircraft. All the updates they're doing to it. There's our airstrip right down there. Fly out of ways and our altitude. We could come down a little faster, I guess. Pull back that torque. But I really like the way I've got the Bravo throttle quadrant set up for this one. It's really kind of fun airplane to start up. And a little trim in there. Just getting turbulence. So we have the ability to split the screen. And we can
Attachments. Map, let's go main flight display charts. There we go. Approach. It's got marathon. Runway. 7. There it be. Now, how to control. Nice. So then we can come in and go chart options. Let's go back. Sync PFD. We'll do that too quick. Goofed that up, didn't I? Okay, let's get back here. Okay, enough of that. We got our chart. Let's go back. Arrival. There we go. That's what I want. Alright, below 200. Initial separator on. Landing lights are on. Too bad you can't grab that and pan it. That's cool. I believe our first flap's around 170. That's cool. Take a flap.
things. So the control feels great. Oh my god, nice. Take gear down. Bit of drag pulling that nose down. On. Gear down, one flap to go. Flap and y'all damper to go. Got a bit of trim there. There we go. Zip on the power, a little more trim up. Do some of that speed. Full flaps, yaw dampers away. Nice and light. Yeah. So as always, I gotta taxi in and shut the plane down. Practice starting it back up. At 4, should be no factor. And then with the power, 75. Turn the pressure away. It's floating in. Oh, this is so nice. Time to look out the wing. attachment pair. Here we'll shut down, do an engine restart just to practice it. Nice park brake set. All right, so I turn off our taxi light. It will pull this lever back, put it into that side, and then we come over here, it will go 1, 2. Oh, that's so cool. Alright, now we'll do a start. We'll go. Watching NG. Got 19.8, it stabilizes. Introduce fuel. Watching ITT for a hot start. Watching, was it NG for a hunger start? A good start. So there we go. High idle. Right here. Beta. Okay, now cut off. We're going to come back with that lever. And then 1, 2. Sweet. So we're gonna do this door again.